Welcome to a video on the washer method for determining volume. This video will show how to use the washer method to determine volume of a solid when rotating about an axis other than the x or y axis. Let's start with a quick review. To use the washer method, it's important to sketch a representative rectangle that is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. So if we have a horizontal axis of rotation, our rectangle would look like this. And since the width of the rectangle is delta x, we integrate with respect to x as we see here. The outer radius, or big R of x, would be determined by the red function, and the inner radius, or little r of x, would be determined by the blue function. If we have a vertical axis of rotation, as we see here, then the representative rectangle would look like this, again, perpendicular to the axis of rotation. But now the width, or you could think of it as the height of the rectangle, is delta y. We integrate with respect to y. So the outer radius would be determined by the blue function, and it has to be expressed in terms of y, and the inner radius would be determined by the red function, also expressed in terms of y. And lastly, when we integrate with respect to x, as we see here, a and b will be along the x-axis, and when we integrate with respect to y, we'll integrate from c to d along the y-axis. Let's go and take a look at a couple examples. We want to determine the volume of the solid generated by the bounded region of the given equations rotated about x equals 5. So we have y equals the square root of x in red. We have y equals 0, which is the x-axis, and then you have x equals 4. So our region is this region here, rotated about x equals 5. So we have a vertical axis of rotation. If we rotate this about x equals 5, it will look just like this. So we'll determine the volume of this solid using the washer method. So the most important thing to do to set this up properly is to sketch a representative rectangle that when rotated would represent one washer of the solid. And this rectangle is going to be perpendicular to the axis of rotation, something like this. So the height of this rectangle would be delta y, which tells us we have to integrate with respect to y. So let's go ahead and see if we can set this up. First, our limits of integration have to be in terms of y. So the y interval would be from 0 to 2. When x is 4, the square root of 4 is equal to 2. So we'll integrate from 0 to 2. Next, we have to determine the outer radius based upon this axis of rotation. Well, that would be the distance from the red function to the axis of rotation. And that will take some thought. Well, this distance here would be big R of y, but it's going to take some thought to determine how to express this. We know the distance from the y-axis to the axis of rotation is equal to 5 units. So if this is 5 units, if we could determine this distance here, we could take 5 minus this distance, and it would equal r of y. Well, this distance is equal to x based upon the function y equals the square root of x, but we have to express this in terms of y. So we have to take the equation y equals the square root of x and solve it for x. So if we square both sides, we have x equals y squared. So this distance is equal to y squared determined by the red function, which means big R of y is going to equal 5 minus y squared. We do have to square this, and we have to subtract the inner radius. Well, little r of y is going to be the distance from this vertical line to the axis of rotation. That's 1 unit. So little r of y is just equal to 1. We have to integrate all of this with respect to y. So now we'll square this binomial. So we'd have 25 minus 10y squared plus y to the fourth minus 1. Let's go ahead and combine our like terms. So 25 minus 1, that'd be 24 minus 10y squared plus y to the fourth. Now we'll find the antiderivative. So I'll have 24y minus 10 times y to the third divided by 3 plus y to the fifth divided by 5. and we'll evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration. So we'll first replace y with 2 and then y with 0. So 24 times 2 minus, this would be 10/3 y cubed, and y is 2, times 2 to the 5th. And then when we replace y with 0, these will all be 0. And to save some time, I've already calculated this. It comes out to 416 pi divided by 15 cubic units. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at one now rotated about a horizontal axis. So again, we have the same function, y equals the square root of x bounded by y equals 0 and x equals 4. So here's our region rotated about y equals negative 1 now, so we're rotating it about this axis. If we do that, it's going to produce a solid that looks just like this. So using the washer method, let's figure out what this volume would be. Again, our representative rectangle is going to be perpendicular to this axis, so now it's going to look like this. And since the width of this rectangle is delta x, we'll integrate with respect to x as we see down here. So this distance here will be big R of x, and this distance here will be little r of x. So the volume is going to equal pi times the integral from 0 to 4 along the x-axis now. Now for big R of x, so the distance from the red function to the x-axis would be the square root of x. But since we're rotating about y equals negative 1, we have to take the square root of x and then add 1 to it. So the outer radius is going to be the square root of x plus 1, and then we square this, minus the inner radius, and this distance here will always equal 1. So again, we have minus 1 squared, and now we're integrating with respect to x. Okay, let's go ahead and square the quantity square root of x plus 1. So we're going to have x plus 2 square roots of x plus 1, and then minus 1. Let's go ahead and simplify this. I'm going to go ahead and write 2 square root x as 2x to the power of 1/2, and then plus 1 minus 1, that would be 0. Let's go ahead and find this antiderivative. So we'll have x squared over 2 plus 2 times x to the 3/2 divided by 3/2. So let's simplify this and then we'll perform the substitution. So we'll have 1/2 x squared. And here we're going to have 2 times 2/3, that'll be 4/3 x to the 3/2. And now we need to evaluate this at 4 and 0. So we'll first replace x with 4. Then when x is 0, everything in here will be 0. And you can go ahead and check this, but this does come out to 56 pi over 3. Which again would be the volume of this solid created by rotating this region about the axis y equals negative 1, as we see here. I hope you found this review helpful. Thank you and have a good day.